Even if we go higher up the defensive ranks nationally, they're fourth in the nation in total defense, and they're only giving up like 15 points per game. Now, some of that is a byproduct of playing a bit of a weak schedule. Nobody in the non-conference. Rutgers was the best game that they played there. They didn't have to face USC on the other side. But still, you're facing offenses that are putting up 30 and 35 points per game and limiting them to 15 to 20 per game. So Washington with an outstanding defense. Now, the difference for me on the Washington side from last year's college football playoff team is no John Ross on the offensive side to stretch the defense and make the huge plays. They still have Dante Pettis on the outside, and the defense is really good, as we can see statistically, but if you watch them play, they're not quite of the caliber that we had last year with all the NFL talent that Washington lost on in the defensive backfield. They really struggled this past week, even at home, as like an 18-point favorite against the Utah team that's been struggling at 5-5 going into the game, and barely pulled out that game. I caught the second half of that game against the Utes. Just your thoughts about Washington football. Still a quality team, one of the top 15 teams in the nation, but not necessarily where they were at this time last year.
Yeah, and it makes me sick to say that as a Husky fan, that UW is a good team. But, I mean, their defense, you know, they don't have Buda Baker, who's with the Cardinals. You got Sidney Jones, you got Kevin King, all those guys went to the NFL. So, I mean, they don't have those guys in the backfield. And Tyler Huntley with Utah kind of, I don't want to say necessarily lit them up, but he definitely exposed them, the secondary, that is. And, I mean, with the offense, like you said, Dante Pettis is the only guy that they have that's on that receiving corps that really scares me is their next opponent. But, I mean, their opponents in general, you don't have a John Ross who's in the NFL now, who could, you know, get down the field. And he certainly did in last year's Apple Cup and had, I think, at least one receiving touchdown. I think he had like 140 yards. I could be wrong. But, I mean, he definitely was that threat, John Ross was, where, you know, it was, you know, you got to watch out where he is going to be because he will take it. He's a deep threat no matter what. Dante Pettis, I like him more as a returner than a receiver, obviously, because he has the NCAA record for most punt returns for a touchdown. Receiving-wise, he's done all right, but I think Tavarius Martin Jr. with Washington State is a better receiver statistically and overall. I know that's going to make a lot of people mad, but that's just how I see how it is. Jake Browning struggled against Stanford, and that was interesting to see. He tried to make something out of nothing at the very end and couldn't do it. But, yeah, I mean, the UW, if you compare the UW and WSU defense with that game against Utah, WSU's speed D forced 7 turnovers. They had 3 picks. Huntley had 3 picks. They had Troy Williams come in for a Hail Mary in garbage time, so that was their 4th pick. And then Mataafa, like I've been saying, I mean, not only the best name in college football, but probably one of the best D linemen in college football. He definitely I think he stripped 2 balls or 2 fumbles that he recovered. And, I mean, that Washington State defense as a whole, you know, played really well against Utah, and it was really inspiring. The only thing that sucked was it was a 7-point win, but we had 7 turnovers that we had forced with Utah. So it would have been nice to see them win by, you know, 2-3 touchdowns instead of a 7-point win. Whereas with UW's defense, I mean, yeah, they're great statistically, but there's nobody on that defense that really scares me that says, like, oh, man, if I'm thinking one matchup I want to watch, it's this guy against this guy. There's nobody on that UW defense that – I mean, as a unit, they're great. Maybe it's Vita Vea at like the most, who could be a first-rounder in the NFL. But, I mean, other than that, there's nobody on that UW defense that's like, okay, I know him by name, and I've known him for the last 2-3 years watching these teams, and I'm like, okay, he's gonna ball out. He's going to have a good game.
And we don't know the status of Azeem Victor, who missed the UW
game. That is correct. Yeah, he got arrested, I want to say, about a week ago. I think it was for shoplifting. I could be wrong. Can't remember what it was for. But, yeah, he was suspended for the Utah game, and it'll be interesting to see if he comes back for the Apple Cup.